Students, in the present video session, I'll explain Career Sense Multiple Access, that is CSME. So CSME was developed in order to minimize the collision. Suppose if you are minimizing the collision, obviously we can improve the performance. So in the case of CSME, each station sends the medium before sending the data. So that means each station will check whether the transmission medium is free or not. So if it is free, the stations can send the data or packets. So CSME requires each station first check the status of the medium. Afterwards it can transmit the data. So the major principle under CSME is sends before sending the data. Sends the medium before transmitting the data. Sends before transmit. CSME can reduce the collision, but it cannot eliminate it. Consider one scenario in which the stations are connected to a shared channel. So collision may exist because of the propagation delay. When we consider two stations, for time being, station 1 and station 2, and one more station 3. So everything is connected to a common channel S2 and S3. So when station 1 sends the frame, it starts sending the frame after checking whether the medium is idle or not. If the medium is free, the station 1 can start sending the frame. But the first bit of the frame which was sent by station 1, it will be transmitted over the transmission medium, and it takes some amount of time to reach every other stations. So in order to reach every other stations, it takes some amount of time and every stations to sense it. So at the same time, now S2 will sense the medium. It will sense the medium and it finds that the medium is free or idle. Then once again S2 starts sending the frame. S2 is also start sending the frame, because the first bit sent by S1, the first bit sent by S1 has not yet been received by the other stations. The other stations may think that the medium is idle, and it can sense the medium and it can start sending the frame. The diagram shows space-time model of a collision in the case of CSME. So we can observe that at time t1, B starts sensing the medium and it finds that the medium is free or else idle, and it can start sending the frame. Similarly, at time t2, station C will start sensing the medium and find it as idle, and therefore the station C starts sending the frame. So now why exactly the station C thinks that the medium is free even if the station B is already started to send the frame? Because the first bit sent by station B have not been reached station C. So now both the stations will think that station B and station C, both the stations will think that the medium is idle, and both the stations will start sending the frame. So because of that, both the signals will collide with each other and both the frames are destroyed. So we can say that even if the stations can send the frame after sensing the medium, if the station the medium is free, then only stations can send the frame. If you are adapting this concept also, there may be a chance of collision because of the propagation delay. The collision may exist because of the propagation delay. Vulnerable time in CSME. Vulnerable time is nothing but the length of time in which there is a possibility of collision. So in the diagram we can observe that during time t1, station A, it will sense the medium and it can start sending the frame. So but station D can sense the first bit of station A after time interval t1 plus tp, where tp is nothing but frame propagation time. So here we can observe that at this respective point, station b can sense the medium and it can start sending the frame. Similarly, at this particular location or point, station c can sense the medium and it can start sending the frame, but already station A is sending the frame. So because of that, there may be a chance of collision in the case of CSME. So this area shows the vulnerable time. So we can say that vulnerable time is nothing but frame propagation time TP in the case of CSME. Persistence method. What should a station do if the channel is busy? Similarly, what should a station do if the channel is idle? So, whenever the channel is busy, what exactly the station can do? If the channel is idle, what exactly the station can do? So, in order to answer these two questions, we can adopt three different persistence method. The first one is I-persistent method, second one is non-persistent method, and third one is P-persistent method. So, we'll take one by one in detail. I-persistent CSMA access mode. So, which is simple method, and we can say that I-persistent method is straightforward method, which is simple and straightforward method. So, in this case, the stations can check the medium, continuously and the stations can get the status of the medium, like whether the medium is idle or busy. If the medium is idle, the stations can continuously send the frame. So that means each time the station need to sense the medium, and later it can transmit the frame if the channel is idle. So this type of method, we can say that there will be a highest chance of collision, because all the stations can sense and transmit the frame continuously. So because of that, there may be a chance of collision. In such instance, the sender can wait some random amount of time with the probability of 1, and later it can attempt to transmit the frame again. So this kind of I-persistent method can be used in CSMA bar CD systems including Ethernet. So here we can observe that each time the station can check the status of the channel. If it is free, if it is idle, stations can transmit the frame. If it is busy, once again, it can check the status of the channel. But here, there may be a chance of collision. The second method under persistence method is non-persistence method. So in the case of non-persistence method, each station can transmit this data or frame after sensing the channel. So now initially the station will sense the medium or channel, and it finds that the channel is busy. So now the station will wait some random amount of time. Once again it will start sensing the channel, and again it finds that the channel is busy now. Once again it will wait some random amount of time unless or until the channel becomes idle. So once again, after some interval of time, the stations will sense and transmit only if the channel status is idle or free. So now we can avoid the collision. We can avoid the collision while compared with the high persistence method, because we are considering, or we are considering the waiting period, that is some amount of time, that is wait random amount of time. So in the flow diagram we can observe that each time the station need to check the status of the channel. If it is idle, so the stations can transmit the data, or else it need to wait some random amount of time. Once again it need to sense the channel, and if it is idle, then only it can transmit the data. But in the case of non-persistence method, it will reduce the collision, but it will reduce the collision as well as it reduces the efficiency of the network, because the medium remains idle even if there are many stations to transmit the frame. So both the stations, two or more stations will check the status of the medium, but one more station is already sending the data, and within fraction amount of time that respective station has completed the transmission of frame, but both the stations will remain under wait period. So therefore we can say that P persistent method, which combines the advantages of I persistent method as well as non-persistent method. So in the case of P persistent method, which can be used if the channel has the time slot with the slot duration, channel has the time slot with the slot duration should be greater or equal to maximum propagation time. So if you are using P persistent method, we can minimize the amount of collision as well as we can improve the efficiency. So now we'll take two steps under P persistent method. The first one is, with the probability P, the station can sense its frame. The second step is, with the probability of Q, that means 1 minus P, the station waits for the beginning of the next time slot and checks the transmission medium or channel again. If it is idle, the line is idle, it can go to step 1. That means the station can sense the frame. So if the line is busy, it acts as though a collision has occurred and uses the back off procedure, that is TB. In the case of p-persistent method, the stations can continuously sense the status of the medium. So if it is busy, the stations need to wait some random amount of time. That may be wait a backup time or wait a time slot. Unless or until this condition is satisfied, the stations need to wait. So with the probability of P, the stations can transmit the frame. Flow diagram for the p-persistent method is shown here. Initially, the stations need to check the status of the channel. If the channel is busy, that means if it is true. Channel means busy. If it is true, so the stations need to continuously check the status unless or until it becomes false. That means channel busy, if it is false in the sense the channel is idle. So now generate a random number R that is equal to 0 to 1. The value of the random number, it varies from 0 to 1. So now we have to compare the random number with the probability P. So if R is lesser or equal to P, the stations can transmit the frame. If it is true, the stations can transmit the frame. So if it is false, with the probability of Q, that means 1 minus P, the stations can transmit the frame. So that means with the wait period, that is wait a slot. So once again, it need to check the status of the channel. If it is true, that means channel is busy. If it is true, use backoff process as though the collision occurred. So it need to wait some random amount of time, that is TB. After that, once again, the stations can sense the medium and it can start transmitting the frame. So if channel busy, if it is false, generate the random number R and it can compare with P. If it is true, the stations can transmit the frame. So this is how, in the case of p-persistent method, the frames can be transmitted with the probability of P. If the probability of Q, that means 1 minus P, the stations need to wait for the beginning of the next time slot. So here, in the second method, so if the line is idle, if the line, or that means the channel is idle, So with the probability of P, the stations can transmit the frame. If the line is busy, so we can say that there is a collision occurred in the transmission medium. For any queries, please mail me at sadhana.b@canaraengineering.in. Thank you.